Hi guys, it's Romina. Welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I'm gonna be doing this super beautiful and bright manicure for the summer with this float out pattern. This is reverse stamping, and I'm gonna be using Olive & June Summer 2021 collection. So if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you're new, and let's get started. I'm gonna start applying my base coat. This is the first base from Essie to protect my natural nail and to make this manicure last longer. Then I'll be applying my base color. This is gonna be White Night from A. England, and I'm gonna be using just one coat to make the colors really pop. For the stamping, I'll be using Uber Cheek Nice and Negative with this float out pattern here. To stamp, I'll be using Holotaco Electrostatic. This is a regular nail polish, and also the Ice Cube Stamper from Maniology. If you guys are interested on getting some products there, you can use my code TINY10 for 10% off. As I'm using a regular nail polish, I have to make sure that it works super fast, because otherwise it's gonna dry up and it's not gonna pick up the design. Then with a scotch tape, I'm just gonna remove all the excess, and I'm gonna start filling out the designs with the colors of this collection. If you haven't seen my swatch and review video on this collection, I will link it here so you can check that out. There are 7 different shades, super bright and super beautiful for the summer. And I'm actually super excited that I got this collection, because some other brands did some neons this year. I mean, the trend was neon for the summer, but this brand was the only one that had all the colors of the rainbow, so that's why I chose this collection. And all the colors match perfectly together. They're not creams and they're not jelly, so they're kind of in between. So sometimes you're gonna need 2 coats, and I incorporate this blue, even though these are supposed to be leaves and maybe green, but I just wanted to add all the colors from this collection, so I just put some blue. So who cares, you know? It doesn't really matter. So here's what it looks like after I finished to paint this color. And now I'm gonna do the same thing for my other finger. So I'm just letting this stamper dry a little bit, and I'm gonna start with the second one. So I'm gonna try to imitate the same pattern but with different colors in the other one. So here I'm using 2 stampers, as you see. So while I'm painting this one, the other one is drying up, and that saves a lot of time and a lot of work. Now, if you only have 1 stamper, it's possible. I've done this before and it's not a big deal, as long as you have time and the patience to just wait, because you have to let it dry, put it on your nail, and then start with the other one and then let it dry again. So it's gonna take longer. So here are both stampers. I really love how the pattern turned out. All the colors are super beautiful. Then I'll be applying liquid latex in my ring finger and my middle finger. This step is not mandatory, but it's gonna make things easier. Then I'll be applying 1 coat of the Orly Bonder to get that stickiness back into my nail, because the polish is already dry. And I will let it dry for 30 seconds to 45 seconds before I put the stamp on my nail. After I put the design on my nail, I just dab it a little bit with my finger just to make sure that it's completely stick to the surface. So now to remove the excess, I'm just gonna use a wooden stick or a cuticle pusher to make sure that I cut the border and I separate the design from my finger. So then with some tweezers, I'm gonna remove it, and something like this can happen. This time I didn't cut enough, so the design got stuck to the liquid latex. Then I'm gonna cut the excess on the tip with some scissors, and I'm just gonna repeat the same process on my ring finger. This time I'm using a cuticle pusher, the other part of the cuticle pusher, and I'm gonna remove the excess. I also use a scotch tape to remove the excess that got underneath my nails, and I also use it to clean up the cuticle area before I go with the cleanup brush, because this technique is a little bit more clean. But anyways, I'm gonna be using a cleanup brush. This is the Twinkle T number 2. This is a super good brush. I recommend you to use. Here's my code if you're interested. So then I'm gonna be cleaning just the borders of these 2 nails, and I'll be applying Lime Fizz. This is the green shade of this collection, in my pinky nail and in my index. I'll be applying 3 coats because this shade is a little bit sheer, but with 3 coats I get full opacity. You can do a little bit of cleanup later if you need to. This is the WhatsApp Nails number 4 cleanup brush. Then I will apply the Manology Smudge Free Top Coat on top of my designs to make sure that I don't smudge the black nail polish. Unfortunately, in my ring finger I made a mistake and I actually apply a regular top coat and I smudge it. Then I'll be applying the Good To Go from Essie. This is a dry fast top coat. I really love this one. It dries up super fast and it gives that smooth and shiny finish at the end in all the nails. Last step, as always, I'll be applying cuticle oil to make sure that everything is moisturized. And here's the final result. I really love this combination of colors. This floral pattern is absolutely gorgeous. So here's with the flashlight so you can see that holographic particles in the black polish. Here are the pictures for this manicure. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, leave it a thumbs up. Thank you so much for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.